Morning to all. Myself Suswara. This is Shadali Adish. Our topic is about assessment of knowledge about study disadvantages and the difference of mode of delivery in movement. Introduction. As we know, mode of delivery is most sensitive and vital parameter of health sector. There are two types of deliveries, normal vaginal delivery and your veins cesarean section. Usually, cesarean section is operated when the normal vaginal delivery goes back to mother or baby or both. According to WHO, since 1985, for nearly 30 years, the international healthy community has considered the rate of cesarean section to be between 10 and 50%. It is taken as normal range to increase the health standards and reduce the mortality rates in high-risk pregnant women. There are many life-threatening conditions where C-section is prerequisite. The absolute indication for cesarean section can be placenta previa, abruptio placenta, severe preeclampsia, failure of progress during labor, and medical conditions. And so, despite many disadvantages, increased rates observed mainly due to lack of knowledge. Our aim, to assess the knowledge in women regarding the impact of neonatal omagonal morbidity and mortality on elective cesarean section with that of normal vaginal delivery. Our objective is to determine the proportion of women willing to have elective cesarean section based on their knowledge. Methods. This is a cross-sectional study which was performed on pregnant women of first child without any disorders and reproductive age group women without any previous history of delivery. A total of 122 women participated in the study. Informed consent was received from the participants after obtained clinical approval. The study is conducted in two separate study settings, Kudipatnu Village Rural and Adilabad City. A pre-tested questionnaire containing 15 questions was used to collect the data and assess the knowledge of each woman by giving score. That is 1 point obtained for correct response and 0 for incorrect and unidentified responses. Knowledge is then assessed as good, moderate and poor based on points from 11 to 15, 6 to 10 and 0 to 5 points. Data was entered in Microsoft Excel version 2019 and statistical analysis was done. Chi-square test is used to find the proportion and p-value of less than 0.05 is considered statistically significant. Our result is, mean age of the participants is 21.56 plus or minus 3.036 and minimum and maximum age of the study group is 19 and 30 respectively. Majority of the age group are in between 20 to 23 years. 87 of women lived in city and majority of the participants were educated above 80. Totally 27, that is 22% of the women opted for cesarean section, 78% opted for normal vaginal delivery. Cesarean rates in urban versus rural, 28.7% of the women in urban and 5.71% of the women in rural have chosen for elective cesarean section. Percentage of the women opted for cesarean section based on education status. So, women studied below 10 to 12% of the women studying below primary school and up to high school chosen for elective cesarean section, and about 25% of the women who studied above degree chosen for elective cesarean section. These are the questions we put to them to assess their knowledge. 23.25% of the women with good knowledge, 20.8% of the women with moderate knowledge, and 25% of the women poor knowledge chosen for elective cesarean section. Coming to this question, here women participated in this study are making decision about the change of birth method. One of the important factors affecting their decision is the knowledge about delivery method. In developing countries, lower education level is responsible for poorer knowledge. Level of education is significantly associated with level of knowledge. Also, other research has shown that education has significant influence on knowledge of cesarean delivery. Similarly, we found that lower education level associated significantly with poor knowledge score and knowledge level. With a p-value of less than 0.01, it is highly significant. In present study, 27 to 22% of the women are selected as elective cesarean section without any medical indications for reasons of fear of pain, feel safe, feel comfortable. In our study, percentage of the women of elective cesarean section is 22%, which is approximately same as the study conducted by Gandhi, which is 21%. The high frequency of unnecessary cesarean section could be due to women or providers choosing their option after previous complicated birth, previous cesarean section, and lower informed and educated women about vaginal birth and associated pain and management. It is reasonable to inform the pregnant woman about the risk of each of the above categories in addition to counseling her regarding the potential risk of a cesarean section for the current and any subsequent pregnancies. The clinician's role should be to provide the best evidence-based counseling possible to the pregnant woman and respect her autonomy and decision-making capabilities when considering route of delivery. These are some of our references.
What research case you have done this study?
One thing I will ask you, make it clear, whether you have done in 1980 women?
Yes.
So, intended delivery you are telling, sometimes you are telling as if delivery has already happened, it has like
intended.
Then you are telling elective they have already opted and they have got it done. So you are confused a little bit. So it is intended only. So they want to plan for
first time.
How many times? Which time is there? How many weeks?
Non-probability.